क्वेश्चन नंबर 4, डायमीटर ऑफ अ रोलर इज गिवन इन एज 84 सेंटीमीटर, लेंथ इज 120 सेंटीमीटर, इट टेक्स 500 कंप्लीट रिवॉल्यूशंस टू मूव वंस ओवर टू लेवल अ प्लेग्राउंड, सो फाइंड द एरिया ऑफ द प्लेग्राउंड. नाउ वी नो रोलर इज इन द शेप ऑफ सिलेंडर, इजंट इट? डायमीटर इज गिवन, सो फ्रॉम डायमीटर वी विल फाइंड रेडियस, 84 बाय 2 that is 42 centimeter. Okay, length of the roller is given means height, isn't it? This is height only, so this can be treated as height. Now how 500 complete revolutions is given to level a playground. We know to level a playground only curved surface area of cylinder is used, isn't it? So first we will find curved surface area of roller. So CSA of roller will be equal to CSA of cylinder only, because roller is in cylindrical shape. So 2 pi r h. So 2 into 22 by 7 into r is 42 and h is 120. So from 7 we can cancel, 7 6, isn't it? Then it will give 44 into 12 6 are 72, so 720 will come. So this 720 we can multiply with 44. Okay, so we will get our final answer, that is CSA of (31,680 cm². Okay, so now this is CSA of roller in one revolution. Now we know 500, for 500 revolution CSA of roller, or we can write area leveled in 500 revolution. So 500 multiplied with 31,680. Okay, so 3 zeros, so you can put 3 zeros and you can multiply with 5. So 5 8s are 40, 5 6 are 30, so 34 will come. 5 1s are 5 plus 3 8, 5 3s are 15. Okay, so 1584 00 centimeter square. Now if you want to convert this into meter square, we can convert into meter square, because such a big number. So what we will do? We will divide by 10,000. Okay, so 40 will go. So now this number we got in meter square. So this much area is for 500 revolution. Okay, but this is what? Nothing but area of the playground, because to level the playground we need 500 revolution. So area of playground is equal to same 15,484 meter square. Question number 5, a cylindrical pillar, see here directly it is mentioned, it is pillar is cylindrical in shape, is 50 centimeter in diameter. That means we should find radius, isn't it? So radius we will find here. Radius will be 50 by 2 centimeter, that means 25 centimeter. Okay, height is given 3.5 meter. So now see, this is centimeter, this is meter, so both should be in same unit, so any unit you can convert. So I will convert here 25 in meter, suppose, so divide by 100. So we know 25 ones are 25 fours are, so 1 by 4 meter we can write. Height is given, then rate of painting is given. Okay, cost of painting curved surface of the pillar. So here it is given, we should find curved surface. So CSA of pillar first we will find, that is 2 pi rh. So 2 into 22 by 7, r is 1 by 4 and h is 3.5, isn't it? So see, 2 2s are 4, 2 cancel. Then 2 1s are 2, 11s are. And then 7 1s are and 7 5s are 35. So 11 into 0.5, isn't it? But we know 11 5s are 55. Then after how many digit decimal is there? One digit, so 5.5 meter square. So this is CSA of pillar, isn't it? Now cost of painting for 1 meter square is 12.5 rupees. Okay, so what we will write, cost of painting for 5.5, how much we got? 5.5 will be, we should multiply these two, isn't it? So after multiplication, what you will get? 55 and 125. Five, seven, eight, and 6. So 68.75 rupees is the cost of painting. In question number 6, curved surface area of cylinder is given. Radius of the base of the cylinder is given. Height we should find. So we'll start with formula of CSA of cylinder, which we know is 2 pi r h. Okay, so this is given 4.4. 2 into pi is 22/7. R is already given 0.7. H is unknown, so we will write H as it is. Now cancel 7 ones up. 7, isn't it? 4.4. This 44 into 0.1 into H, isn't it? So this 44 ones up, it will give what? 4.4 only. So H will be 4.4 divided by 4.4, that is 1 meter. So this is required height. Question 7. Inner diameter of circular well. We know circular well is in cylindrical in shape, isn't it? So inner diameter means this value is given 3.5 meter. And height of the well given, it is 10 meter deep, so this is 10 meter. Okay, so height is 10 meter, we can see. So inner curved surface area, inner curved surface area means 2 pi r h. We know curved surface area is 2 pi r h, and inner means, for that we will use inner diameter. Okay, so first of all, from diameter we should find radius, because in formula radius is given. So inner radius, we can say inner radius will be half of diameter, isn't it? Now we will keep this as it is. Now CSA of inner circular well will be 2 pi r h. So 2 22/7, 3.5/2, height is 10 meter. Okay, so see, this 2 will go, 7 5s are 35. Then we'll be left with 22, 0.5 into 10. If you multiply 10 into 0.5, you will get 5 only. So 5 into 22 will give 110 meter square. Okay. Now this is first part of the question. In second part, what is given? Cost of plastering this area is 40 rupees per meter square. So cost of plastering 1 meter square is 40 rupees. So for this much square meter, we will get 40 into this. Cost of plastering 110 meter square will be 110 into 40, which will give 4,400 rupees. Question number 8. In a hot water heating system, that is cylindrical piping of length 28 meter. So we know cylindrical piping length is given 28 meter, isn't it? That is nothing but height of the cylinder. Diameter is given 5 centimeter. So that we will convert it into radius. And this unit also we need to convert here, because one is centimeter, one is in meter. Now radiating, we should find the total radiating surface in the system. So we know heat will radiate from the curved surface only, not from the top and bottom face, isn't it? That means we should find here curved surface area of this cylindrical pipe. So first of all, radius is equal to 5 by 2 centimeter, okay, and curved surface area of pipe equals to 2 pi r h. So here this is in centimeter, this is in meter. So 28 into 100, or what we can check, this centimeter we can convert it into meter, okay, that will be easy. 5 by 2 divided by 100 we should do, isn't it? So we know it will give 1 by 40 meter, okay. So 2 22 by 7, r is 1 by 40, h is 28. Now we know 7 4s are 28, isn't it? Then 4 1s are 4 cancel, then 2 5s are 10, so we are will be left with 22 by 5, which will give 4.4 meter square. Question number 9, interlateral or curved surface area of petrol storage tank should be find, okay. Diameter is given and height is given. So diameter, from diameter we can find radius. (4.2 / 2) that will give 2.1 meter. So CSA of petrol tank, 2 pi r h, 2.1, and h is 4.5. so see, this will give 7 3s, we know. So 44 into 0.3 into 45, which will give, see, this will be 44 into 3 132 13.2 will come, isn't it? And this is 4.5, so 13.2 and 4.5 will be 5940, but after two digit decimal is there, so we will put after 2 digit, so 59.4 meter square, okay. Now the second part of the question is, this is the area. In second part of the question, it is given how much steel was actually used if 1 by 12 of the steel actually used was wasted. So here we don't know how much steel is used, okay. So we will suppose let x meter square steel is used. So how much is wasted? 1 by 12. So 1 by 12 x of the original used is wasted. So 1 by 12 of x means 1 by 12 into x, or you can say x by 12 is wasted, okay. So if this much is wasted, so total will be, so to make petrol tank actual steel used will be x minus x by 12, okay. What we can write here, area of steel used to make tank, so it will be 12 x minus x by 12, which will give 11 x by 12. But we know actual used steel in making tank is given as just now we found 59.4, isn't it? So x value we can find from this, 59.4 into 12 by 11. So from 11 we can cancel, 11 5s are 55, then 11 4s are, so from 12 you can multiply this to get 64.8 meter square. So this is what actually used steel is, 64.8 meter square. In question number 10, it is given that see lampshade is given to you, okay, and it is divided into three parts. Then frame has a base diameter, diameter is given 20, height is 30 centimeter. Now margin of 2.5 centimeter is to be given for folding it from the top and bottom. So 2.5 margin here, 2.5 margin here, okay. So total height of the lampshade we can consider here 30 plus this, isn't it? So total height we can write 30 plus 2.5 plus 2.5, which will be 35. It is in centimeter. Diameter is 20, so radius will be 20 by 2, that is 10. Okay, now we should find the area. Okay, so we know area will be curved surface area, so we will write curved surface area of lampshade 2 pi r h. So 22 by 7, r is 10, h is 35. So 7 5s are will go, then 5 2s are 10. So 22 into 100 means 2200 centimeter square, isn't it? All these units are in centimeter. Question number 11. Students of a Vidyalaya were asked to participate in a competition for making and decorating pen holder. We know pen holder will be of this shape when top is open, isn't it? To keep pen inside. Okay. So now we should find the total surface area for such 35 pen holders. So first we will find surface area for one pen holder. So one pen holder means curved surface area and one circular area, isn't it? So for that height is already given. Height is given 10.5 centimeter. Then radius is given 3 centimeter. Okay, so we can write area of cardboard required to make pen holder. Will be 2 pi RH plus 1 circular area, isn't it? Top is open. So here see, we can take common pi R. So we can write inside 2H and 1R. Okay, 22 by 7, R is 3, 2 into 10.5 plus R is 3. So 66 by 7 into this will give 10.5 into 2 will be 21 plus 3. Okay, so 66 by 7 into 24. So now we can cancel this. From 7 we can cancel. So 7 3s are 21, we know. So 3 will be left, isn't it? Then 7 4s are 28, then 2 will be left, then 7 2s are 20. So 66 into 3.42, that will give 226.28 will come. Okay, so 226.28 centimeter square. So now this is area of one pen holder. Such 35 pen holder we required. So for 35 pen holder, what we should do? We should multiply these two. 226.28 into 35. Okay, this we should multiply. So what we will get? 5 8s are 40, then 14 will come, 31 will come, 7919.8 cm square. Okay.